यू पीपल जस्ट कन्वे देम व्हाट इज द प्रॉपर फॉर्मेट एंड हाउ दे कैन ज्वाइन. ओके सो लेट्स कम टू द प्रेजेंटेशन. बिफोर दैट यू जस्ट लेट मी नो इफ माई वॉइस इज गेटिंग एंड आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द स्क्रीन ऑल्सो. सो इन दैट सेंस यू पीपल जस्ट लेट मी नो. Is it visible and is my voice also audible to you? Okay, fine. So I think you're getting my voice. Okay, fine. So yesterday we talked about that how we people can encourage the other people, and also we people also seen some phrases that how we can just complain regarding something. So for that, you people just don't put your attendance right now. I will tell you when to just you have to put your attendance. So maybe Vishaka and others also, you just take note. Right now it is not necessary, so you don't put attendance right now. I will let you know when you people have to put your attendance. Okay, so after that, next we people have the slide which is related to remember or forget or remind, etc. So we will begin from this. Here is your first slide for today, which talks about that remembering. So what happens normally, sometimes we people have to stretch our memory, we have to recall, or sometimes we have to just remember some events or the people that we met in the past, and some incidences might have happened with them, and right now we may be talking about them. So that time we need to remember, and then also reminding. So what do you think might be the difference between reminding and remembering? So reminding is somewhat different and remembering is different. So when remember comes, that time we ourselves are trying to remember something, recall something, and reminding, that time we are just reminding it someone else, maybe about the time of the meeting, maybe time of the class, maybe something, some events about that, we are reminding others. So that is reminding, and something that sometimes we may forget also. Okay, so you people just try to see how we people may just remember or remind or forget. So your first phrase is like this: I will always remember, or I will never forget. Okay, so both mean same. You can use either one. You can say, I will always remember your help. So if the same sentence, I would like to say it in negative, so it will be like this: I will never forget your help. Okay, so you people just try to understand that here, when there is dot dot dot, you can replace it with number of other examples. So I just told you that I will always remember help, I just told. So here you can replace it with that: I will always remember the way you have just helped me to complete my project, or the money that you have given me, or the maybe medical help or economical help that somebody might have done, or something that is remember, or the maybe any book that you have given to someone. So that things we people are going to remember, or we are going to forget. So you can use always and never. They convey the same. And here, remember and forget, they are opposite of each other. And this way, you can just use either like this or like that. Then, next, you people may just say like that: if I remember correctly. So, if I remember correctly means, as far as my memory, as far as I can remember. So, what I can remember. So, as I told you, if I remember correctly, we people have finished phrases related to encouraging someone and complaining someone. So that way you may just try to remember. So what I did here, as per my memory or as per what I can remember, based on that I can say after this. So here, when here is dot dot dot, so that time you just try to just remember that what you can just remember, or what you can just okay, just 1 minute more. So what you can remember, or as far as what you can just do regarding this, maybe as far as I can recall, and that are also same, that it indicates. So whatever you know, whatever you have experienced, based on that, what you are going to say afterwards this. As far as I can recall, yesterday we have completed the quiz. Okay, so this way you people just try to say. Then there is next phrase that you may use like this: I have a vague recollection of. So what do you mean by vague recollection? So here your memory is not strong, you're not remembering exactly and correctly. So that time this is called vague recollection. So vague is not clear. Vague means unclear. So unclear memory. So maybe you don't remember. Suppose last year you people might have gone to picnic, and there you have enjoyed something with your friends. So you are just remembering how many people you were there. So you may be remembering some of them exactly, but some of them you're not sure whether he was there or she was there. So what you are just trying to say, you're saying, I have a vague recollection of the memory that last year we went to picnic at this particular place. So that vague recollection will indicate that something that you are going to remember, but not clearly. It is faintly you are remembering. So in that sense, you may use this. The next important that you may just say that something is on the tip of my tongue. What do you mean by tip of my tongue? So if you are just saying something is on the tip of my tongue, it means that you know it very well, and but right now you are not able to remember. So it happens with us. Suppose that you are remembering the name of your friend, maybe a distant friend is there. You know his name, and but right now you are going to talk about him, but right able to remember his name. So that time you may just say, his name is on the tip of my tongue, or something happens like this. We are trying to remember the name of village, a particular village that we know, its name we know, but right now we are going to talk about that village and we want to remember the name of that village, but in this case you are not able to remember. So that time you may just say, it's on the tip of my tongue. So I'm trying to remember, but I can't quite remember right now exactly. I just not getting this. So that time you may just say, tip of my tongue. Okay. Then next, you may just say, my mind went blank. So when does it happen? Have you experienced like this? Your mind went blank. Maybe see example like this. You have prepared for speech competition, let's say, and there you have prepared your speech very well. Maybe it is your maiden speech, or it is your first speech. Okay, and you are just went on the stage and you started your speech very well. So after saying few sentences, then you realized that because of fear, you see a lot of people in front of you. There is a large audience and they are looking at you. So you just have fear, nervousness, and then what happened? Because of that, you're not able to continue your speech. There you have forgotten everything, and at that moment you're not able to remember anything. Okay, so that condition is called mind went blank. So my mind went blank. It indicates that I couldn't remember or think of anything at this moment. So that time you may just say, my mind went blank. Okay, so again, you just try to use these phrases for oral communication as far as possible. Then next, we people may just have phrases for same. Phrase is that it doesn't ring a bell. See, this is not familiar for us, or we cannot go for plain meaning. Ring a bell means that simply what we know, ring a bell, that we hear some voice and that ring a bell. Maybe a bell rings, a doorbell, or maybe mobiles ring, that is also bell, or some bells that ring. So that meaning we just expect, because we are going that way only, that what we know the meaning of ring and what we know the meaning of bell, based on that we try to guess the meaning of that sentence. But here it is not expected. Here this is not context to understand that voice of some bell. No. So if somebody says that it doesn't ring a bell, it indicates that it doesn't sound familiar. It means that it is not seen you, or you have not heard it, or you're not read it before, and in that sense you may say that it doesn't ring a bell. Okay, so this is a phrase, ring a bell, and if you search it into the dictionary, maybe probably you just check it on online, maybe put into Google also, so you may just say it doesn't ring a bell, or you just try to understand and you just try to use it in your own sentences, then it will be fine. Probably you people may just note down into your notebook or somewhere on paper. Otherwise, see, simply right now, if you are reading and listening, you will find that it is very simple. I understand everything in this slide. But maybe if my lecture completed or finished afterwards, maybe after 1 hour, you don't remember anything. So it is always better that you should develop a habit of note making. So what is note making again? So everything, whatever you learn, whatever you just see, if you attend the lecture, of course, whenever it is required, you should have pen and paper with you, and you should note down what you think important, what you think that you don't know, what you think that you have to search more information about that particular word, topic, or concept. Okay, so in this case, if you don't know ring a bell, better you have to note it down, ring a bell, that I don't know this phrase. I have to check its meaning, or I have to search its examples. So afterwards, you may just refer these notes, what you have just noted down, and afterwards, you may just take more information. So this is a good habit. You may be just doing anything, not for as a student, but as a person, as a professional, you should always develop the habit of note making. Okay, so now come to the point. Let's go to the next. You may just say like this, please remember to, and please don't forget to. So till now, up to this, all the phrases, they were related for remembering. Okay, so now these are the phrases, please remember to. So these are phrases for reminding now. So here you are going to remind someone. What you are going to remind? For example, please remember to call me in the evening. So you are telling your friend that you are reminding your friend to call you. Okay, so please remember to call me in the evening. Or similar again, you may just say, please don't forget to call me. Okay, so again, these are similar. Remember and forget, they are opposite of each other. But here we can use it, maybe one with positive and one as a negative, but meaning will be same. So you may just replace it, or probably I can ask you people to put some examples in chat box also. You people can put. So let me just say, please remember to attend the meeting. Please remember to go to the function. Please remember to complete your exercise. Please don't forget to bring your notebook. So likewise, you people may be just simply you are making your own examples, and important is that start using them with oral communication. Then the next phrase is regarding reminding about something. So I would like to remind you about, and then you just put something here. You may just say, I would like to remind you about the meeting that we people have to attend. I would like to remind you about the assignment that you have to submit tomorrow. I would like to remind you about the project that you have to complete. I would like to remind you about the work or anything. I would like to remind you about the maybe any event, function, organization that you're going to see or attend anything, so that time you're going to remind somebody. Then next, you may just say you haven't forgotten to or about. Here you can use these both prepositions. You can just say you haven't forgotten to call me, have you? So this is a question tag actually. I hope that you know what question tag is and how do normally make a question tag. So if here if the helping verb is have and there is not, so we people make question tag positive. So and we take pronoun from here. So this is a question tag of this. You haven't forgotten to tell me the truth, have you? You haven't forgotten to give me your notebook, have you? Likewise. Or you may just use about like this. You haven't forgotten about the maybe you say just a function today. You haven't forgotten to the guest lecture today. Okay, so that way you may just try to send. Afterwards you just use question tag. So this is a question tag, have you is a question tag. But see, do you remember, have you just gone through that you have used a question tag somewhere in your oral communication? Normally people don't use, but you people can make question tags sometimes when you are just making a statement and you wanted to assure that your listeners also confirm the same what you have said. So that time you just try to confirm it with question tag. So I may just say like this, you are all listening to me, aren't you? It means that you are listening. I just wanted to confirm you. So if I say you are attending the class, aren't you? Or you have completed the homework, have you? So that way you people just try to use the question tag for your communication. So here this is an example of question tag that we people can use in oral communication. If you remember that as far as you people were learning English grammar, it was just for getting marks we people were learning question tag. But here you people can use it for oral communication also. Then let's go to the next point here, that you may just say it completely slipped my mind. And when you say slipped my mind, here it is not anything that mind is not a physical entity which can sleep. The way we sleep, you may slip your leg and you may fall. But here, what about this mind? So when you say it completely slipped my mind, it indicates that I completely forgot about that particular thing. Maybe you are asked to submit the assignment today and you have forgotten to bring it. So that time you may just say, it completely slipped my mind. Okay. So you just try to know the meaning. Also note down, this is a phrase, slipped my mind. So then there is next slide, which is about phrases that we people can use to talk about something which you find very easy. And sometimes you may find something which is very difficult. So how do we usually say, we know these words easy and difficult. So we simply say it is easy and it is difficult. But apart from these two ways, there could be number of other ways that you people may just get. So here you will get these 10 phrases that you people can follow. Okay, so as far as, is it clear? Are you getting me? Now you people just give me somebody reply. Maybe unmute you, or maybe you just put in chat box that you're getting it. It is visible, it is audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So again, you people, now you can put your attendance. You can start putting your attendance here. You can put in chat box. You have to put only your division and roll number. So you may start putting your attendance in chat box. Simultaneously, people have to pay attention also. Okay, so how we can say something is easy? First of all, we'll talk about how we can say it. So you'll get the phrase here. One more phrase that you people have to note down, that is a piece of cake. So when it comes, it's a piece of cake. So what do you think it could be? So piece of cake, if we say, so in front of your eyes, you may be just celebrating the birthday of your friend and there you may get a piece of cake. Does it mean the same? It is not at all. So if you say it's a piece of cake, it means that something is easy, for that it is used. Okay, so you just try to understand and use it. So something that you feel that is very important to do and you find it very easy, so that time you may just say it's a piece of cake. So maybe for you, or maybe for someone else also, if it is easy. Then again, here you'll find the new word. So if you don't know the meaning of this word, you people have to put it into dictionary. You may just check into online dictionary and then you may just say it's a cinch. Again, similar meaning that it is used to convey that something is simple, something is easy. So that time you people just start using this. Then again, it's a breeze. So breeze, you know the basic meaning of breeze? So that will be different. And here, if you're just getting it in this context, it means it is easy. It's a breeze. You may say it's a breeze. So maybe a blowing of cold wind, that is also called breeze. But in this context, it is easy. Next is that you may just say anyone can do it. This is a plain sentence. There is no anything that you don't maybe you can use all the time this phrase. Anyone can do it. That it is as simple as that anyone can do. Again, similar phrase. It is also plain. There is nothing that you have to find out. So there is nothing to it. So all these phrases, you may just come to know that they indicate you're going to say that something is easy. For that, you may use this. Now let's go to the next point, and it will be related to this, how you can say something is difficult. So maybe you get this word and it is also simple, that hard. So if you say it's hard, it means it is difficult. Then next phrase is that it's a bit tricky. Okay, so when you say it's a bit tricky, it means that it is not easy. It says that it requires some skill. It requires, so maybe you are possessing some skills, or it may be somewhat complicated, difficult. So that indicates that it's a bit tricky. Then next is, you may just say it's really tough. So that time you people may be just saying that it is difficult. So you know that what do you mean by tough? That is difficult. So here it is a new phrase that you people have to note it down, and that is walk in the park. So if somebody is saying that it is not a walk in the park, it means that it is difficult. You don't go for the plain meaning that walk in the park, it means that actually going into the park and walking there. No, it is not like this. So what you people have to just understand it, that you think of someone or something that is very difficult to do, and you just say it is not a walk in the park. And for example, I can say to become a scientist is not a walk in the park. Or you may just say like this, to become an engineer is not a walk in the park. Okay. And here is the last one, that you may be just getting this word again new, that it's very demanding. So you know the meaning of demand, but if it comes in this context like this, it's very demanding. So that time it is different. So it means that it takes a lot of time and energy. Maybe the work that you are doing, if it requires a lot of time, it requires a lot of energy. So for that work, you may just say that it's very demanding. Okay, so these were the remaining six phrases that are used to talk about something which is difficult. Okay, so I hope that you people are getting it, and maybe when you people will just come across with new words, you people have to make your own examples. Don't go for something like this, or which is ready made, or which is already there mentioned. If you're just searching the meaning of the word demanding, so that time it is essential you people have to make your own example. And you people try to check if you can make such examples. That means this. Okay? Then let's go to the next slide. Here you may be just getting the words that we people can use to talk about person's age. Okay? So let's see how we may just use some expressions, some words that we people can talk. So here is the first phrase. You may just say, she's in her early 20s. Okay. So early 20s, it indicates not exact 20. So it indicates the years between maybe 20, 21, 22 or 23 years old. You don't know exact age of that person, but here what you're doing, you are just maybe putting your impression that her age might be between 20 to 23 years. So that time you may just say. So it is early 20s. So there could be that early 30s, early 40s, early 50s also. So if it is early 50s, so that time what you are going to understand, early 50s can be 50, 51, 52, 53 like this. So similarly, people have to understand other the decades instead of 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, that also you people need to take into consideration with this. Okay, so likewise, we people have the teenage. So the concept of teenage, when we talk about teenage, that age comprises the years between 13 to 19. Okay, so may it comes teen at the end, 13, 14, 15. So that is teenage. So may think that teen is teen. In my teenage, or likewise, you people might coming into your listening teenage. So that time you have to clear you people getting this. Say late 30s, it is not exact 30s. It is again a guess that might be his age is between 37 to 39 years old. So in between somewhere, so 37, 38, 39, that can be his age. So again, if it is late 30s here, you may be just getting the phrases like late 40s, late 50s, late 60s, late 70s also. Okay. Then here you may just talk about his exact age. If you know that how much age of that person is, maybe you may just say she just turned 6. So you may just replace this 6 with other ages like this. You may just, she just turned 12. He just turned 20, 21, 25 like this. In case you know his age, so that time you may just use like this, or you might be just celebrated his birthday. So in that case, you people can use this phrase. Next, here is again important expression that you may come across maybe in your reading, or maybe you listen such kind of words somewhere, might be instructions, act your age. So if anybody is saying you act your age, so at that time, what you are expected to do? So that time you're expected to behave purely. So is my voice breaking? I got some kind of this. Is it clear or is it still breaking? Are you getting my voice clear right now? Okay, so I'm getting yes. Okay, fine. So if it is not getting, you just let me know. So maybe from my end, I don't find any issues. Maybe you people check from your end if your network or everything properly. So that will work. So now come to the point here. I was talking about act your age. If somebody is saying this, so that time what you are supposed to do, you have to just behave properly. So in that sense, your behavior is immature, or it may be you are behaving like a child, it indicates. Or you may use it for someone who is not behaving properly, so that time you may warn them by saying act your age. So if you're saying act your age to someone, it means that your age is more and you are behaving like a child, that indicates. So here explanation is given like this: use this when an adult is behaving or is being immature and acting like a child. So that time you may just tell them act your age. Then there is next, that I'm not as young as I used to be. So here just comparison, that In earlier days, I used it to be young, but nowadays I'm not young. So it indicates that now I'm becoming old. So that is the way that you people have to use. Then again, the same. Here is also you are going to get one more phrase, and that phrase is over the hill. You people better note it down that what do you mean by over the hill? So, I'm over the hill. It means that it is an expression to say old. And if it is not, it means that you are over the hill now. You may just say, if you think that any person, his behavior or his having, maybe he's forgetting something, so that time you may just say you are over the hill now. And if you're just saying you are over the hill now, it means that you are old now, you are becoming old now. Again, new word is here, that spring chicken. So if you're just thinking about this, he's no spring chicken. It indicates he is not young. So spring chicken indicates that, yeah. And if it is negative sentence including no, it means not in. If I just saying he's spring chicken, it means this, that he's young. Then next is that he's I beyond her years. Okay, so it indicates that she's young, but she has the wisdom of an older person. So it may happen that sometimes the people who behave more maturely, maybe they are behaving like older person, but their age is not that much. So that time it is used like this. She is wise beyond her years. Then next is that I'm having a senior moment. Okay, so it's a senior moment also. It means that being forgetful. Becoming old, and becoming old, it comes with this forgetfulness. Maybe if you have seen some people when they cross their 60, 65, 70. So that time, what problem face? The problem face of being forgetful. So being forgetful, if you found that any person is facing problem of this, so that time you may just say you are having a senior moment, or you may say I'm having a senior moment. If you're just not able to remember where you kept your pen, where you kept your specs, where you kept your something, and you're not able to remember it, so that time you may just say, you can use it with a fun also. Maybe you're not, your age is not, but you're not able to remember. So that time you may just say, or you may be joking by saying like this, you are having a senior moment. And here is the last one, that he lived to a ripe old age. So that is only we are going to talk here, that old age we know. So if the person is living more than maybe 80 years, that is old age. But a ripe old age, that indicates a very old age. If you have seen a person who lives more than 80 years, 85 years, 90 years, maybe more than 90 years also, so that time for that person you may just use this, that he lived to a ripe old age. Okay, so these were the phrases that we people just discussed. Among this, if you just don't know any meaning of any word or any phrase, so that time you may ask. I already told you that you people have to note it down, and you people have to search on the internet also. So today we are going to have this much here as far as our presentation is concerned. And last time I think we started one activity also, that two students, they are going to speak on some topics. So that is also you are not going to remind me. Maybe I might have forgotten, but you people have to remind me. So let me know, has anyone prepared today from both divisions A and B? If I ask personally, then people maybe just they try to run away. They just disappear. They get disconnected. They have internet issues. So better you just come on your own. I know there are many more students who are having the skill, ability. Here you just need to take the lead. If not, so then we'll stop. I'll stop my sharing my screen and I will just get the quiz. So you just stay connected. So today you people will get a quiz which is based on articles. So you people have to put correctly articles a and the. So I'm going to paste the link in chat box. People just click on that. I pasted the link. You just click on it and join immediately. Apart from that, you people have to put your attendance also. So join immediately. I can see 5 students joined so far and others are joining. All people have to join. So I will wait for another minute, and after 1 minute, you are going to get your quiz started. Join fast. Only few students, half of the students have joined. Remaining students, join fast. Once again, I will paste the same link which is in chat box.